From the previous two videos, we understood the importance of router-outlet directive and app-routing.module.ts. In this video, we will understand about the routes defined in app-routing.module.ts by directly walking through the code. In line number 6 of app-routing.module.ts, a constant named routes is defined. It is defined of type routes. From the import, we can see both router module and routes are defined in router.d.ts. To navigate to the source code of routes, I am holding Ctrl key in keyboard and clicking on routes. This opens router.d.ts in the line where routes is defined. From the earlier videos, we already know that this file also contains the definition of router module and router outlet. Now, coming back to routes definition, we can see that it is defined as an array of root. If we go to the source code of root, which is again in the same file, we can see that root is an interface containing various properties. Let me collapse some of the comments so that we can have a clearer view of the initial set of properties. We can see the properties path and component included. The root interface is provided by Angular to define the routing and navigation information of an Angular application in a structured way. The objects of routes array in app-routing.module.ts is defined based on root interface. The path and component property included in the object is based on the properties of root interface. As path property value, any path URL of our choice can be provided. We provided getting-started and attribute-directive to define our own path names. We linked each path with a component by defining it in the component property. Based on the needs of our application, we can define any number of routes within the routes array. Hope this clarifies how routes for our Angular application is defined and assigned to the constant named routes. In line number 12, we can see that when the router module is loaded, we can see routes constant passed as input. This means that the router module is loaded based on the routes constant that contains navigation data. Hope this explanation gives an understanding how routes are defined in an Angular application. Let me open app.component.html and display it in a separate window. To implement routing, we included router-outlet tag in app.component.html, then we included the routes in app-routing.module.ts. The explanation provided in the previous two videos and current video should help you understand about the coding we implemented for routing. Based on this understanding, in the next video, we will understand how routing works.